So I think most of you that know the codes of Google Code Coin would be the traditional trademark for the information. However, we in our work we do find that if the consistent activate of the Google Code Coin signal may be in contrast that you promote the tumorigenesis in pancreas. I think some of the speakers mentioned today that one of the key cancer type, pancreatic cancer, is one of the most lethal type of cancer. And because of the overall survival rate has not been improved in the past 10 to 20 years. And the key reason is that the time of the diagnosis, more than half, actually, some doctor told me that more than 80% of patients, they are diagnosed with metastatic cancer. So our goal is want to determine, in order to detect the pancreatic cancer earlier, maybe we should focus on more about how pancreatic cancer was developed, especially the key event or key factor affecting the early development of pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma. So we focus on how the genetic factor actually contribute to the early development of pancreatic lesion as well as the progression of pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma. So in general, because after the whole genome sequencing has been done in quite a few medical centers, so people know quite a lot about how pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma was progressed. So initially, more than 90% of the patients were suffering from the KRAS mutant, followed by breaking out some cell cycle checkpoint. So the cancer will start to progress. So in general, it can be classified into two major stages. So first, the pre-malignant pre-cancer lesion, so stage from panning 1, 2, 3, then followed by the become invasive carcinoma, then the metastasis. And this event was associated with initially the KRAS mutation, followed by, for example, P16 activation or P53 deletion or the SMARCA4 deletion. So in general, they can be classified into this stage. But recently, people find that to link the normal pancreas to the pre-cancer lesion pannings, people believe the origin of this pre-cancer lesion is because of the ductal reprogramming, or we call awesome to duct metaplasia occurring in the pancreatitis. So we are thinking maybe if we can find a way to investigate how the early event was happened, was occurring, maybe we can link how the early pancreas was developed. So in fact, this concept has been raised in the 80s. People already think that the arsenic to ductal metaplasia might be the initial event for pancreatic cancer. In fact, people say it's origin, the cell origin of the pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma. And our two key questions we are trying to address: what's really the key regulator which triggered the initial ductal reprogramming during the pancreatitis, and whether this key mediator which may be the mediating the early development of pancreatic cancer. So we are trying to find what's the key mediator for the ductal reprogramming. So in general, since people know about how the genetic factor possibly contribute to pancreatic cancer, so we try to set up the animal model in order to monitor how pancreatic cancer was developed in vivo. So in general, by combining different animal strategy, including we use a cellular to induce pancreatitis in the mice, we try to conditional express the KRAS G12D mutant in adult certain pancreatic cell lineage. And also followed by we are breaking down the cell cycle checkpoint by, for example, knocking down the one allele or P53. Or we can, in combination with white monitoring how those KRAS mutant expression cell become the tumors, we crossbreeding all these mice with dual reporter mice DEG in order to use the GFP label to mark those KRAS mutant cell. In general, we also try to combine with different GRELAX mice system in order to determine how KRAS mutant was expressed in different pancreatic lineage, which lineage is really the cell origin of the pancreatic ductal adenocarcinoma. So in general, we can use mouse strategy to reproduce quite a few status, for example, from the normal pancreas to pancreatitis, you can see a huge amount of adaptive reprogramming has occurred. After it's conditionally expressed, the KRAS mutant, you can find those adaptive lesions become the precancerous lesion painting structure. And also, by applying the 3D image strategy, also demonstrate that those ductal lesions actually not developed from the middle part of the duct. In fact, if you look at this picture, you can see all the duct lesions which actually was occurred at the terminal of the pancreas. In fact, that's the asana, the position of asana tissue. So, and after KRAS mutant was expressed, those ductal lesions was expanded, was altered, and showing the precancerous morphology. Or this 3D image made more clear. You can see the ductal trees, and those ductal lesions was indeed was occurred in the terminal of duct, which is in the asana tissue. So that's why we express the KRAS mutant in asana tissue that can induce the cancer lesion formation. Then we move to use this model, try to further dissect whether those glucocorticoid treatment are whether or not beneficial for pancreatic cancer treatment or actually is promote pancreatic cancer formation. So initially we had to try to collaborate some medical doctor to collect some specimens. So collect, for example, we collect the patient who has undergo surgery for the chronic pancreatitis. Not surprisingly, we found that those glucocorticoid receptor was overexpressed in the patient with chronic pancreatitis. And people have been already know that glucocorticoid receptor belong to a nuclear receptor family. So when they activate by the glucocorticoid, they can transfer okay to a nucleus and play as a suppressor role to suppress certain gene expression or activate certain gene expression. And in fact, they are disrupting the kappa B signaling. That's why they can act as anti-inflammation agent. Not only that, we also try to collect the patient specimen from the different stage of cancer, including the adjacent tissue. So we find that either stage 1 to 2A or even stage 2B to 4, we found that actually the receptor was overexpressed. In fact, we found the accurate nuclear glucocorticoid receptor was actually activated in the advanced stage of the patient. That indicates not only in the early stage, but also in the late stage, all the glucocorticoid receptor was activated at the disease state. So we are wondering whether we can combine the model I just mentioned in combination with a conditional glucocorticoid receptor knockout strategy to determine whether the receptor in activation of glucocorticoid signaling is important for either the early phase or important for the late phase. So, as I mentioned earlier, how we induce the early lesion formation or early ductal reprogramming, we basically can combine with treat the mice with a ruler to mimic the pancreatitis status. We can inject the mice with tamoxifen or 4-HT in order to induce a knocking KRAS mutant expression. So in combination with pancreatitis and KRAS mutation, we can find that the mice start to development into the precancer stage. So in contrast, we knock out the glucocorticoid receptor. You can see the ductal reprogramming status induced in pancreatitis was greatly reduced. And if together with the KRAS mutant activation, sorry for the small figure, but basically you can see that we analyze one panel of the marker in the histology analysis for those mice either treated with a pancreatitis inducer or treated with the pancreatitis inducer together with the glucocorticoid receptor knockout. So you can see that all the marker was reduced in the knockout status. So in the KRAS mutant status, so in the inflammation status, the ductal reprogramming was reduced. So in the KRAS mutant activation status, we can all see that knockout receptor will significantly inhibit the lesion formation. But alternatively, we can see that some lesions still form in the knockout status. Why? Because we are using the conditional knockout status. So as you can see here, for the region doesn't have complete the glucose receptor knockout, they still form the lesion. For the region, they complete receptor knockout, they stop the lesion formation. That's indicating the activated glucose receptor actually mediate either pancreatitis or KRAS G12D mutant driven tumorigenesis. How about not only use the inflammation to trigger the pancreatic early cancer development, but also whether we can direct activate the glucose receptor by treating the mice with the ligand dexamethasone. So we have set up protocol by treating the KRAS mutant mice either with dexamethasone together with this activation of the KRAS mutant. So that you can see that so non-treated mice don't develop precancerous lesion, indicate KRAS mutant alone was not sufficient to induce early cancer development. However, for the mice have to inject with dexamethasone, some lesions start to form at the 10 weeks of time. For the 14 weeks of time, you can see the enlarged lesion was formed. If you compare the pancreatitis induced cancer lesion and the dex treatment induced cancer lesion, actually they have a very similar feature. For example, in the lesion region, we can see the activate glucose receptor followed by activate the stromal, small muscle active positive stromal. And also those lesions become ductal lesions, express some ductal feature like a CK19 expression. They also become the mucin positive or has an abundant mucin expression, indicating the dex induced KRAS mutant mice to form the precancer lesion are very similar to the pancreatitis-induced cancer lesion formation. So if the mice were further crossbreeding to BP3 knockout mice, we find that single allele BP3 knockout was sufficient to trigger the precancer lesion further to become the invasive adenocarcinoma. It's just by we can obtain some metastatic tumor either in the lung or in the liver. In this status, we are trying to determine how and why the activation of the glucocorticoid receptor can mediate or can promote the pancreatic cancer formation. So we have come out to find that for the mice that are in the pancreatitis status, we find that actually the SAC was phosphorylated, indicate that in the pancreatitis stage, SAC signaling was activated. But for those mice that's a knockout receptor, the phosphorylated SAC status label was reduced. The same finding was seen also in the KRAS mutant mice together treated with the pancreatitis. So for those mice as a knockout glucose receptor, the phosphorylated SAC label was significantly reduced. It was also proved by using the immunohistochemistry, also confirmed that for the mice with the knockout, receptor knockout, so not only the lesion was reduced, the level of phospho-SAC was reduced. So the mechanism seems indicating that the activation of the SAC may be mediate the development of early cancer promoted by glucocorticoid. So we diagnose the Tycho's experiment by using a lot of mice. So all the experiment, the Western blood was done in the mice, not done using the cell line. So we treat the mice with a dexamethasone and collect the tissue from 1 hour to 48 hours. So as you can see that after mice we have been treating with dexamethasone, so start from the 4 to 8 hours, we can start to see the SAC activation followed by the ERK, MAP kinase activation. And the same kinetics can observe in the KRAS mutant mice as well, suggesting that activation of the glucocorticoid signal actually also activate the SAC activation in the KRAS mutant mice. So the same result was confirmed by immunohistochemistry, so demonstrate that the tech treatment indeed can activate the SAC phosphorylation followed by ERK phosphorylation in the lesion region, not only the KRAS mutant mice, also in the KRAS mutant mice together with the PIP3 knockout mice. What's the mechanism? So whether the SAC is a key mediator for those effects promoted by Google Cookie Code. So we have been trying to apply for the SAP inhibitor in these mice by treating the mice either with the low dose of the dasatinib or high dose of the dasatinib. As you can see by the immunohistochemistry analysis, you can see that for those KRAS mutant mice, it did not treat with a SAP inhibitor the great development of the cancer lesion. But if you treat with the low dose of dasatinib, we see only very tiny regions still from the lesion. And in the high dose of dasatinib, most pancreas lesion was not formed in pancreas. Not only in the KRAS mutant mice, in the KRAS mutant mice, there is a single allele between knockout mice, so the tumor was formed in the control mice, but the tumor doesn't form in the dasatinib treating mice. The data also proved by the Western blot suggesting indeed that dasatinib treatment can suppress the SAP phosphorylation. The data actually was correlated with the clinical specimen, basically showing that for those high-grade pancreatic cancer, they have a high level of the glucocorticoid level as well as the phospho-SAP level. And what's the key mechanism for how the glucocorticoid signaling can activate for SIG SAP pathway? Well, we find that actually SAP was complex with the HGAP protein 19 complex was inactivated in the HGAP protein complex. However, when activation of glucocorticoid, the actually SAC will release from the HGAP protein complex in KD. After they can release from HGAP protein 19 complex, then allow the SAC to be activated in this status. And the activation of the SAC actually was together with activation of invalidate the RAS signal. That's indicating that's why the RAS signaling can further upregulate in the KRAS mutant mice because the SAC allow the RAS activity can be high activated. So basically, our animal model work, we basically explain the situation is that how the pancreatitis, how the long-term chronic pancreatitis would be the risk for the pancreatic cancer is because the chronic inflammation status might be to endogenous of a glucocorticoid receptor was activated. And consider activate of glucocorticoid receptor may lead to the SAP activation. Why the SAP allowed to be activation is because activation of glucocorticoid receptor will dissociate the SAP from the GPR19 complex. Then the SAP activates, they can further either activate the MAP kinase pathway or activate the increase the RAS activity, which will allow the pancreatic cancer to further progress. So our work basically also using, I did not put the data here because of different time, also using the reporter mice confirm that all those GFP positive pre-cancer lesion was direct from the KRAS mutant express in the arsenal cell lineage. And basically we find that the activation of the glucocorticoid receptor pathway not only the key step in the early ductal reprogramming during the pancreatitis, but also it's a key mediator in KRAS-driven pancreatic carcinogenesis. Basically, all the mice work were done by my two PhD students, Dr. Su Jian Zhang and Dr. Lin Pei, together the one of technician, Mao Wanyu. And I also like to thank the collaborator who provide some critical specimen as well as some genetic modified mice. I would like to thank the funding support from my institute, Academia Sinica, and also the grant funding body NHRI and the Ministry of Science and Technology. And thank you very much for your attention.
Very interested subject. Thank you very much for the slides. They look good. Any questions, comments for Dr. Chen? Please go ahead.
Metabolism effect? Yeah.
Yes, indeed, we are investigating that. We think the metabolic alteration actually was the key. But instead, actually, we think that they are altered the Krebs cycle status, not the glucose, glycolysis status.
Because it has been used for making diabetic models in mouse, dexamethasone.
Can you repeat the question?
Yeah, dexamethasone has been used for making diabetic models.
Yes, they affected metabolism of mice, yes. But they are not exactly causing the diabetes. They alter the carbohydrate metabolism.
Thank you.
Is there any epidemiological data that links pancreatic cancer to glucocorticoid receptor? Male to female imbalance, coffee consumption, anything that links what would affect the glucocorticoid
receptor? Okay, we think there are at least two risks actually must link to the phenotype. The first link is I think quite a few patients who are suffering from the chronic inflammation status, endogenously actually, the glucose level is endogenous to control the inflammation. So we believe those patients actually have the higher level of the glucocorticoid. And the second thing is that because actually for those patients who are suffering from the autoimmune pancreatitis, the genetic pancreatitis, then actually they are continuously using the steroid to control. And they actually have a 10 times risk higher than the chronic pancreatitis patient. Suggesting actually that might be the link for the steroid treatment can enhance the risk of the pancreatic cancer. Actually, I also have one more assumption. Recently, people are maybe find the correlation of the people who suffering from a lot of stress and the pancreatic cancer. And actually, the glucocorticoid also was one of the key regulator for the stress. So we think that's all the link actually link to. Maybe that's a risk factor for pancreatic cancer.